Come on, what's wrong, Holmes?
Nothing's wrong. I'm happy.
You ain't happy? What's up with you? ¿Qué pasó?
Really, I'm fine.
Let me guess, you didn't make the football team, is that it?
No, I didn't go out for football.
It's a joke, Ceci. I know you didn't go out for the team. If you had, you wouldn't be 0-7, more like 0-100. I got it. You broke your microscope. Your ant farm got sprayed with a black flag?
No, my ant farm's just fine, and so is my goldfish and my hamster.
Man, ever since me and you first met in kindergarten, I was there 2 years getting my colors down real good. You've been into this science stuff. I used to think you were out the bottle, stuck up. No, I gotta admit, I was wrong about you. You're just a nerd. I figure your kind of people, nerds, and my kind of people, vatos, we gotta come together. I got it. Your calculator broke.
No, my calculator works just fine, but thanks for asking. If I tell you, you won't laugh?
Laugh? Laugh at the vato who helps me in biology? Who wishes in my ear the answers to algebra? Who fills me with history during finals? So what's going down?
It's my heart.
Tu corazón.
Yes, my corazón. Love palpitations.
Love palpitations. That's a hard one to fix, tu sabes? When you fool with your heart, it's delicate. You get inside a person and change things around, but sometimes it's gotta be done.
Do you know how to repair a broken heart?
Simón, I'm the surgeon of all heart surgeons, especially when it comes to romance. Shoot, last week I was on the phone with Justin Bieber. The vato was all heartbroken. He was crying because his girl dumped him right in front of El Pollo Loco.
Bieber? He was crying?
Like a rain cloud. Mira, here comes los canales, Freddy y Tito.
Man, I got a carpal tunnel syndrome from all these handshakes. What's going down, Joaquin?
Unemployment, crime, blackouts, and Martin's broken heart.
Junior Einstein's heartbroken?
When I saw his long face, I thought his calculator was broke.
That's all right, pal, Holmes.
Hey, guess what?
Hey, I don't know.
Freddy found a part-time job.
Washing dishes in a Chinese restaurant. I'ma carry the family tradition.
Seems like Arasa was just born to wash dishes. When did you start?
I started when I was 7. My mom used to make me do the spoons and forks.
Oh, tonto, when did you start the job?
Oh, I don't start yet. I'm next in line.
Don't take the job right away. I think we have to help Marty here.
You guys don't have to. I'll recover.
Martin, you've always helped us with school. We, Freddy, Dito, me, well, we're gonna see you through this dark time.
That's right, we can't let our homie down.
You're the future leader of our people. Plus, we need the answers for the next history quiz. Come on, Marty, smile, don't be so hard. Show a little teeth.
Alright, you jugheads, don't play with Marty. Can you see he's all triste, though?
Triste.
Triste, todo.
Just because I'm a nerd, you're making fun of me. But I have feelings, too. I like girls just like you three, vatos.
Sure you do. Nerds got feelings just like the rest of us, and you're the most suavecito with a 4.0 at school.
You're just saying that.
Nah, it's the truth. Your name is always popping up, like pimples.
They just want me to help them with their homework.
Nah, that's a lie. Last week I heard Belinda Sanchez saying, "Oh, Marty, what a smooth calculator you got."
Chale, Belinda can turn on the charm.
De veras. Last time I saw her, she was painting all over that big digital machine on your belt.
I appreciate that, mi cono, but I know I'm not a suavecito. I'm just another nerd in America. Can I confide in you three?
Confide? Is that anything like safos?
That sounds like a cuss word. Are you calling us out in nerd language? Because we don't take that, ese.
It means can I tell you something? Something personal.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
Yesterday, when I was listening to a song while filling my petri dish with bacteria, I had this strange feeling that the song was exclusively meant for me.
Songs do that, Kendall. They bring up all these dark emotions. You get your ride, bump along Main Avenue, radio up, the girls eyeing you behind the big layers of mascara. Híjole, it's the best experience. So what song was you listening to?
I appreciate you asking, Colonel. I don't recall the title, but I know it went something like this. Molecules, fluctuating molecules, floating in the calculus of our feelings. Molecules, fluctuating molecules, drifting in the stratomolecular bonding. I light you like a Bunsen burner, study you under the microscope. I dissect you like a frog, my barium chromate, my future wife.
I don't know what that was about, but if it moves you, then that's good. Come on, Jughead, give it up. Aplauso. So who's this girl anyhow?
I can't part with her name. My lips are sealed until the rivers run dry and the stars go out like light bulbs.
Stop it with the poetry, Junior Einstein.
Ceci Cortez.
Ceci Cortez? That wild heartbreaker? The best looking girl on our corner of the planet?
Fíjate, Marty. We got experience with bad looking girls, but good looking girls, pues, we don't know much about.
Freddy's right. We're all stupid when it comes to items like Ceci.
Plus, for old man Sleepy, he would tear us up if he found out we were trying to set you up with Ceci.
That's right. We ain't gonna mess with Sleepy's girl.
Man, Sleepy ain't nowhere. I get my homies to do some of this. And some of this. And some of these mean karate chops. I will lay him out flat like a tortilla.
No one better mess with my girl.
Joaquin, you better rethink the game plan. I remember when Sleepy grabbed me by the throat.
I remember, you just got a drink of water at the playground. He grabbed you by the throat like a burrito and water squirted all out.
Yeah, you're right. Sleepy's pretty scary.
You mean you won't help?
You really got the microscope on her, Junior Einstein?
Yeah, I think about her all the time. Yesterday, when I was plotting the equation of the hyperbola of x minus 2 times the radius of the quantity of pi, I just floated off into space.
That's heavy. But instead of Ceci, maybe Julieta or Laura or Ana. Oh, or maybe that new girl from El Salvador, you know, the one that pushes the paleta car on Saturdays?
No, my heart is set on Ceci. I dream about her.
Even what?
Hug my pillow.
Chale, you got it serious, homeboy. Are you kissing it también?
Hey, look who's coming.
Let's hide.
Do you guys smell something? Boys. Four boys.
Ooh, and I thought we were just going to the library to study.
We are. So forget them. Dudes are nothing but trouble.
Let's go.
How come we had to hide?
Practice. We have to practice hiding from girls, like ninjas. In the future, they'll be all over us.
Girls will be all over us?
Some of us, Freddy. Not all of us.
Yeah, I know Ceci since we were little small. In fact,
can't spill it.
I can't tell you.
Charlie, we're your homies.
We're your homies.
Look, your problem is our problem. Unless it means that we might get beat up, then you're on your own.
She stole my bike with training wheels, beat me up, and...
Come on, let it out. It's not gonna keep those repressed emotions.
She called me a bad word. It's not funny.
That's right, it's not funny. A girl who steals your trainer bike will scar you for life.
What does Ceci call you?
I can't tell you.
What do you mean you can't tell us? We know each other ever since we were in Pampers. Little vatos locos, kicking up trouble on our shoulders.
She called me the C-word.
C-word?
She called me a caca.
Damn, that's cold.
Ay, Tito, don't take it to heart. Chin up, be a Marine. What you suffered is in the past. Look at Marty here, he's suffering for reals right now.
It's true, Tito. I'm hurting right here in my core zone.
Thanks, Junior Einstein. You and me know how cruel can Ceci be.
You better leave my girl alone.
But Sleepy, I love her. Let me show you. Molecules, fluctuating
No, Marty. If you sing to Sleepy's girl, he's gonna get mad.
Pues, we're gonna rebuild your body. Maybe drop in a new heart in you.
Like a new engine block?
That's right, like a new engine.
That's right. We'll get some Bondo and we'll fill you up real quick.
Bondo's cool, huh?
Yeah, it reminds me of when we were at the playground, when we used to play with the Play-Doh. Squeeze that thing like masa through your devils. I remember we used to make little Virgin Marys, some Power Rangers, and some cool-looking lowriders.
Remember when we used to make plaster our Paris masks?
Yeah, and yours was so ugly and made babies cry?
Yeah, mine was ugly, huh?
Muy ugly. The good old days at the playground.
Listen, the way I see it, instead of the heart transplant, we go simple.
Simple? We're good at being simple.
Yeah, we'll set up Marty with some mean-looking goddess.
Some khakis and a Pendleton.
Like work on the outer self, huh?
That's right, work on the outer self. And if that doesn't work, we'll work on the inner self. We should take a trip down to La Raza Mall.
I heard of a place. The restaurant is called Tacos Are Us.
Yeah, and the tienda que se llama Big Iguango.
Plus the pawn shop, you snooze, you lose.
You ready to check this place out?
I'll do anything to become a suavecito.
All right, let's go.
Girl, what's wrong with you? He wears a calcanear in his belt.
And his pantalones are all the way up to his throat, like they're choking him or something.
And did you hear what we want to start? A club for people into ant farms.
Qué loco, he's a funny dude.
But he's sweet.
So if you want something sweet, go buy a soda or something.
Girl, I'm not talking about thirst. I'm talking about a guy I can trust. He's better than that no good sleepy. He said he was going to the library.
Yeah, instead he was with you know who.
Yeah, her, Susana.
I'm sorry, he said you and him broke up. I don't know. Like, honestly, Ceci, I'm not the kind of chola that goes out with her best friend's dude.
Now, Flaca is telling the truth. She's really sorry, Ceci. She cried exactly 96 lagrimas, huh, Susana?
It's true. I spilled them tears all over my bedroom. I felt so bad I let Lupe pull my hair for an hour.
De veras, I punished this girl. I'm not trying to be so hard, but it still hurts. I was a fool to trust that sleepy. Now look at him locked up in juvie just because he put his name on West Cement. How stupid!
You better not go out with Junior Einstein.
You can't tell me what to do. You don't own me or nobody. We're through. You're locked away and out of my life. It's like that bad experience I had last year. Sleepy hit on you too? What? What happened? Remember when I was in love with Little Ray and I begged him to let me wear his Raiders jacket? Do you have to bring this up again? The jacket his mom bought with those 100 bolas she won from that lottery? And I lost it? He made me feel so low.
Callate already!
And then I found it.
Oh my gosh.
Under the bleachers? The jacket is my bottom.
Get over it, girl.
It was all dirty and messed up. Put it behind you. That was last year, not yesterday. All right, you're right. In the past, it's gone. We must look towards the future. Mm-hmm. Then he sent me the cleaning mail. He told all his friends about it.
Ay Dios, every time you talk about romance, you bring those Little Ray and stupid Reyes jacket.
But those are cruel.
Malos two-timers.
Low down ratones.
Huevones to a 9th degree.
Espérate, let's not be too hasty. This one right here, he's fino.
He's fine too, the ratoncito in the front row. Mm,
and the one in the back? Look at his eyes. You're my little empanada. Wait a second. We're getting sidetracked right here. This is what guys will do. Distract us from what is really important.
You better not go out with Junior Einstein.
Cállate. You don't owe me or nothing. Can you believe him? He thinks I should do whatever he wants. Forget him.
Maybe you're right. What you need is a guy that's faithful.
Kind.
Intelligent.
I like that. Guy who's kind and faithful and smart. And looks shouldn't even matter, even if he has braces in his teeth.
I remember this one guy telling me she was making out with a girl with braces.
So?
These braces with rubber bands on them, and when they were making out, one of the rubber bands shut into her mouth.
Asco. Looks help, I agree. But personally, I want a guy I can trust.
You can trust me, chola?
Shut up, I said! Dudes, you're always promising things.
It's true. They promise to write love letters, but do they? Mentirosos. I remember this one guy from El Monte. We danced and danced all night and we got pretty close in the parking lot. Julio was chihuahua, hot tamal.
I think I went out with that guy too. He has a ponytail now.
And a kilo of scar on his chin.
And these cowboy boots.
He's a real good kisser, huh?
Yeah, but he kissed me first.
He was only breaking in his ears for me, girl. It was something for him to do while he waited for me to come around.
Guys are so cruel.
Deceitful.
We gotta be careful about guys.
What do you mean?
Do you remember this girl whose boyfriend really turned out to be I shouldn't say anything.
What?
Pues he really turned out to be a chicken.
What are you talking about, loca?
Tú sabes, a muchacha who fell in love with this guy that she met at a club called El Rancho.
And the light turned off and they came back on?
Let me tell it, it's my story. She was this country girl from the state of Monterrey. She was shy and pretty, just like me.
But her parents were strict and stuff, so they wouldn't let her go anywhere. But one night, she decided to go clubbing. She was dancing with this nice-looking guy with a long neck. Then, the lights went off.
Ah!
One of her earrings fell off. She bent to pick it up, and then and there, she realized that her boyfriend had chicken legs.
Piernas de pollo!
It's true. He had chicken legs.
Heck, I already know Martin's a chicken. I can beat him up easily if I wanted to.
You better not go out with him, Ceci.
That does it, no mas.
Joaquin hangs out with those two tontos, Freddy and Tito.
Freddy and Tito? Didn't some tough homeboys lock them up in the locker for the weekend?
That's them, all right. A couple of soft tacos.
Well, Joaquin's cute, even if he can't spell. But how are you going to get your dude?
Yeah, how are you planning to snag Junior Einstein?
I'm going to the mall. I'm going to change my image. There's this store called Nerdstorms. They sell a lot of nerd dresses, nerd shoes, even glasses as thick as magnifying glasses. And they sell a lot of science stuff.
Nah, girl, you can't shop there.
Those are hecka ugly clothes.
You're one of us.
Sorry to let your cholas down, but haven't you ever wanted to be somebody else?
No.
Think about it.
Well, I wanted to be like... Never mind.
Nah, come on, tell us.
Well, I want to be like Barbie.
That's nice.
But a shade of brown Barbie? Better than chicken mole.
I got a confession, también.
You wanted to be like Barbie, too?
No, you know how we dream, pretend? I wanted to be like Selena.
Oh, that's nice. Her música was la mejor.
Maybe you're right, Ceci. It's okay to be someone else. Try something different.
Yes, and Nerdstorm is the place for me. I'm going to hook my nerd.
Like fishing, huh?
Yeah, like a fish. Un gran pescado.
Times are hard.
Plus, in my backyard, all rasquachi.
Hey, look, that's where I got my first haircut.
That's where I got my daddy's jumper cables for Christmas. My abuelita used to work at this panaderia.
And did she used to bring home the pig cookies?
Claro que sí. I bit off their toes, their legs, and then their heads. It was like a horror movie. My teeth were going in like chainsaws.
Hey, where you been?
I want to go see Sleepy.
Sleepy?
I told him that I love Ceci with all my corazón.
And you're not hurt or nothing?
I'm okay, but you should have seen him. Someone had pummeled him. He had all these contusions and abrasions.
Like he got in a fight?
Juve is a hard reality.
I told him that I love Ceci more than my goldfish Melvin. And he's just like, thanks man, you take her.
And you just let her go like that?
It was weird. But then he fell unconscious. So I don't know.
Must have been some fight. Hey, where's Freddy?
He said he was coming right here after work.
The vato got a job already?
Yeah, en el restaurante chino.
First day in the job and they let me off early. Fíjate, I got cookies for you guys. My fortune cookie says, you are a good looking leader and muy valiente. Man, this cookie's right. It wouldn't lie to a homie like me.
Mine says I'm gonna change the world.
How you gonna change the world if you can't even change your chones?
Chuggies, that's enough Chicano humor. So Martin, what's the word?
It says one day I'll be Mr. Universe.
Chana!
These fortune cookies son mentirosas.
You can say that again.
Chana, Chana, Chana!
Was that you, Freddy?
Nel, I thought that was you.
It wasn't me. This place is throwing out some bad vibes y sustos. With all the closed businesses, le dieron gran pelo.
Puro pelo!
Who said that?
You calling us bad names, I said? Come on and show your cara. We'll throw some chingazos. Tito, you handle him.
I don't want to fight. Last time I got into some nasty pleitos, I got all messed up. That'll teach me to mouth off to my abuelita. That vieja's tough.
That's el espíritu de un mal foreclosure. It's kind of spooky in here. Hey, did I ever tell you about this guy from Mexico who could transform himself into a wolf, un lobo?
I heard of el vato. He used to do this transmission thing, no?
Transformation, tonto.
No, it wasn't a wolf. It was a chicken with chicken leg. Tú sabes?
Oh, that's right. He had little skinny legs like Junior Einstein. And when the lights went out during the slow dance, he turned into a real chicken, no? I remember that cuento from when I was a kid.
Yeah, my mom used to tell me that story. And then she would serve us chicken enchiladas and tell us that was the chicken man we were grooving on.
Man, your mom's always been a joker.
It's that voice again, man. This place is haunted.
No, it's the bird. He can speak.
He speaks gooder than me.
He's a bearded macaw, I believe from the upper Amazon.
He crossed a couple of borders? He's illegal? Hey, no one owns him. Let's snag the dude. I mean, the store's all closed up anyways.
Aw, pobrecito. He's probably all hungry. And you guys got crackers?
Look at him eat.
He's a real Chicano bird. Look at him eat those crackers. He's growing on them in todo. Hey, any of you guys ever eat a bird before?
Joaquin, be sensitive. We shouldn't talk about eating birds in front of him.
Okay, I'm sorry, Mr. Tweety Bird. No more stories about fried bird taquitos.
Look, what's that on his pata? Is that a bracelet?
What does it say?
It says Go Dodgers.
Man, I like this bird. He's just a sport. Give me a low claw.
Can we see about my clothes already? That's why we're here, right?
Yeah, Martin's right. Let's get him into his new trajes.
What happened to this place? Everything is closed. Hey, I remember the panaderia. My mom used to buy me the pan dulce and chocolate milk. It was all nice back then, but now it's all really rasquachy.
Even those winos moved out. It wasn't that a crazy business? Cheese and shoes?
Que si zapatos. I remember when you'd buy two pair of shoes.
And the guy would say, I'm gonna cut the cheese muchacha and laugh. Muy loco, viejo.
I remember buying these little white shoes for my first communion. I felt so pretty that day. All I did was look down on my white shoes as I walked down the aisle.
You were religious back then?
No, not really. My mom would just leave me at church. It was boring. So instead, I would just go to 7-Eleven and buy myself a soda and a cookie.
Era muy mala esa.
I know, brown girl. I was bad. I spent all the money mom gave me for the poor so I could buy myself some snacks. So I would just sit down, read magazines, gobble up my goodies, and when I thought an hour had passed by, I went home like this.
And your mom never found out.
No. Whenever she asked me what was church about, I would just say, heaven and stuff. This place is really gone. It needs like a new Latina vision. In fact, I was thinking we should start our own business.
Like what?
I know. How about a nail business? Just imagine all the cholas in the barrio that need sharpening. Forget that. Forget the nails, the hair, the babysitting. We need other stuff. Like, we should go into engineering or become doctors. We can help all the mocoso babies when they come in all sick.
We ain't cut out for that, girl.
Just because we're cholas doesn't mean we can't do something profound.
Well, I've never heard you use that profound before.
Well, I'm using it now, and I'm serious. We should do something more than just be sitting around sipping sodas and eating sunflower seeds.
You mean it, huh?
Yeah.
There's going to be a new me. Now you.
Nel pastel you were next.
Okay, but you better not chicken out. Ceci needs our help.
I don't want any of you spending cheese with mommy shopping at Norm Storms. What will my chola friends say? They'll make fun of me. So don't say anything, okay?
Hey, Tito, come on out. The bird's raw.
Orale!
You too, Junior Einstein. Let's check out sus ganas. He's a little scared to make his entrada. Sort of like a quinceañera for the batito.
I remember when I got my first penitin, I was kind of shy, wearing it around, looking all suave. I was all bad. Yeah, bad on my training wheel bike, so I can understand how Marty feels. Come out, show your gente how you look.
¿Qué hubo, hermanos? ¿Qué pasa?
Man, it's the same old Marty. Put your pants down. I mean, put them down. Don't take them off. Don't wear them all the way up to your chin.
Escuche la música.
Man, you can take the nerd into El Barrio, but you can't force El Barrio into the nerd.
Still the same, huh?
Yep, still the same old Marty. I guess I have to do the operation. Drop in a certified corazón de Aztlán.
Will it hurt?
The operation? Nah, I've done it a couple of times. I made these.
Transmission.
Transformation, tonto. Alright, well, let's go. We gotta get to work.
She's changed.
Yeah, did you see how she wiggled into that nasty old griddle and stepped into that weird dress?
It's like Halloween, like she's wearing a costume. How do I look? Do I look like a nerd girl?
You look different.
I know, but tú sabes, do I seem different? And tell me the truth, flaca, or I'll get real mad.
You sound the same like us, huh, Lupe?
Es verdad. You look different, pero you seem like the same old chola. I know, you forgot something in the store. I wonder if nerds dance. I'll give up everything, but not clubbing.
I see nerds dance, they go like this. Y nosotras, we go like this.
There is a difference, huh?
Mm-hmm.
This is what you're missing. What you do is you look in this end, and you check out all the insectos. And that's how you become a nerd, I think.
What do you see?
I see. My eyelashes.
You gotta open your eyes real big like this.
So, what do you see? It's scary. Oh, it's my fingernail. Oh.
You gotta work at being a nerd. It just doesn't happen overnight, tú sabes? Like us, we weren't born cholas. We had to work on it.
Yeah. You're right. Don't give up. You know what they say. You can take the chola out of el barrio, but you can't take the barrio out of the chola. It's gonna take some time. Bien. I'm going home. I'm gonna practice being a nerd. Hey, wait for us.
How many of you ever want to be someone else? Be a wide receiver or a forward on a soccer team? Go! Or you want to play tennis, but then you're afraid of your friends making fun of you in those white pantaloons. Well, who cares? It's like Halloween, going door to door within your new identity. That's what it's about. I'm ready.
Did you wash your hands?
Simon.
Like when?
Like yesterday, fool.
All right, just checking. All right, grease.
Grease.
Tattoo. Bundle for chest and arms.
Bundle for chest and arms.
Un gorro.
Una gorra.
Alright. Chicano magnetism.
Job Chicano magnetism.
Alright. Tito, el corazón. Jumper cables.
Si, jefe.
Jumper cables connected. Turn it over. Damn, check out Junior Einstein.
The homie looks like a cool bomb.
Cut it with the Junior Einstein. I'm Martin Pablo Alvarez Gonzalez de Vaca.
What's up with the long name? What? You don't know your papi?
You saying something about mi familia?
You put too much Chicano magnetism?
Yeah, maybe. I think so. I think we can't mess around with junior accent anymore. I mean, Martin Pablo Álvarez González de Vaca. Or make fun of his ant farm.
Or his petri dish.
Or put his pants on in the gym.
I like this new image. Grease in my hair, mis trajes, mi gorro.
What about your Chicano magnetism?
That too, fíjate.
Sí, jefito.
I'm on the journey.
Journey?
I said journey. Do I have to repeat myself? Okay.
Is this journey far away? My mom doesn't let me go past the 7-Eleven down Main Street.
This journey doesn't arrive. Something in your heart. Something ethereal. I'm on a journey called love.
I think we added too much Chicano magnetism. Sounds all spacey, Lato.
Hey, I ain't gonna hang around. I'm gonna leave. I need to go wash the dishes at home.
It's not far, Lato. It's right here. Let's walk.
I can't. My mom's waiting me to do the dishes.
That's right. Tita's going to wash and I'm going to dry.
You ain't going nowhere. Now get in line. Walk.
Man, I don't know about you, vatos, but my knees are killing me.
Now check me out. I got the hair, mis trajes y todo, but I don't know if I can take it if Ceci turns me down.
Man, that's the easy part. All you gotta do when you see Ceci is like, well, well, tell him, Freddy.
Simple. All you gotta do is walk up real slow, like a tortuga. And then, pues, like, entonces, Tito, you tell him.
Piece of cake, bro. You tell her she's got pretty eyes? And let's go get down and get married.
I mean, like, that's the head-on approach. To tell you the truth, I ain't had a girlfriend since second grade when I was in love with Marta Ramirez.
Marta Ramirez?
You know Marta?
Yeah, she was my girl.
Marta, the one with pudgy knees and ponytails?
Yeah, she liked me so much, she used to give me a burrito.
Imposible.
Imposible. She gave me a burrito that had weenies, huevos, and a splash of ketchup.
Dude, those were my burritos. Yeah, my mom used to make it for me, packed it with like little animal crackers. Me and Marta was like sucking the patitas, talk about painting your painting, 3+3, todo.
Man, I can't believe she two-timed us, dog.
Man, what a movida that girl threw on me. My mom would pack me lunches, leave at the stove, and I would go hungry, I wouldn't even eat them, I would just give them to her.
Marta, are you sure it was her?
Check out the names on the wall. Maybe we can get some advice from our ancestors.
This wall is almost as old as the Bible.
Who think this is your dad's name?
Yeah, that's my apa's backup, but that's not my mom's name.
Man, quizás. There are all sorts of names here. Belinda con Ralphie, Sara con Julio.
Chorizo con huevos, look.
Man, I think that's my mom's name, but that's not my dad. Jose con Patricia?
I think Jose is my dad. I recognize his placa.
Man, your dad used to like my mom? That's weird. We're almost like brothers, hermanos or something.
That's kind of weird. And just think, if they had never gotten married, we would never been born, never existed. This whole Chicano thing would have been nada.
I'm so glad my mom dumped your dad.
Look at this one. Don't get fooled by plastic love. Real profundo. Kind of like a Chicano Socrates.
Yeah, like when Marta Ramirez gave me Joaquin's burrito. Man, I feel really low.
Hold yourself together. Be strong.
I'm trying, but I'm giving us chucos a bad name, crying on stage, but it hurts.
I know it hurts. We've all been there. That's better.
There's all kinds of names. Armando con Patricia.
Patricia con Ralphie.
Ralphie con Carolina.
Carolina con Chato. And look at this. Joaquin con Susana. Joaquin con Susana. Hey, Romeo, are you this Joaquin?
Look at him smile, his gran gallito smile. Is this Susana that's friends with Ceci?
So?
That's cool. You like Susana, I like Ceci. But these vatos here are left in the cold.
Ni modo, we can find a girl anytime.
We can?
Simon, all we gotta do is call one of those 1-800 numbers. Or, look at that chiquitita over there.
And over there.
Look at that wild chick over there with the wild hair. She's looking kinda cute. What's your number, girl?
That's enough drooling, you dogs. Let me go buy you guys a soda. You guys really fix me up.
You're alright, bro. Let's go.
Soda's for everyone.
Do you think there's something wrong with Ceci?
No, she's changed. She's different from before.
Yesterday when I went to her house, she had a bird feeder, an aquarium, a pet turtle, a butterfly net. And she was laying in her bed and
Instead of reading Lowrider magazine, she was reading National Geographic.
Ceci has changed.
But you know, maybe she's right about school. Maybe we gotta study a little harder. We can maybe be nurses.
Not nurses, doctors.
Hey, I like that, doctors. We can help our gente when they're sick.
Yeah. Or we could become veterinarians, take care of the dogs and cats from el barrio.
Claro que sí, they need help too.
Yeah. Ceci's just going through a phase right now. We gotta stick by her, you know?
Like peanut butter and a flour tortilla, we have to stick. Hola, mis amigas. How are you guys doing? How do I look? You look really, really different. But a good different. I cut my fingernails. No, you didn't. Oh my god, yes you did. But she has the nicest fingernails in the barrio.
Your mascara. It's gone.
Y mi mariposa. You got your tattoo laser?
It's gone. I'm going to snag my nerd.
I even got my Chicano books, economics, pre-calculus, chessboard, microscope, and I got a calculator exactly like Martin's.
I thought this was kind of big for a pager.
I'm sure he'll be impressed.
Did you know that in order to move your queen, you have to at least make 3 moves? I read it in a book. And also, the queen termite, she is 1,000 times bigger than her subjects. Do you think Martin will like me?
Like is not the word. You're a dream come true.
Ceci, we're really worried about you. Like, we really love you. Why can't you be a homegirl like us no more? Without the ozone layer, cosmic gases could reach Earth.
Sounds fuchi.
We gotta do something to bring her back.
It's all Sleepy's fault. He treated her like dirt.
That's for sure.
If this girl goes crazy on us, we need to bring a curandera to help her out.
Or a priest, like the girl from The Exorcist when she was twisting her neck all around and acting weird.
Stuff like that really happens. ¿Qué pasa, homegirls?
Kicking back, hanging.
Susana, Lupe.
You know our names?
Sure, I see you around school.
You go to our school? I don't think I've seen you before.
Nah, me and Lupe would have noticed a pretty face like yours.
Maybe you weren't looking hard enough.
Nah, me and Lupe are always looking, huh, girl?
Siempre.
I was around. Maybe you were too busy to notice. So I'm Martin Pablo Alvarez Gonzalez de Vaca, but I go by the name of...
Be calm, listen. Don't let them know who you are.
I'm what you call someone with a split personality.
That's good. One personality for me and one for Susana.
Oh, hi.
I said hi. You look remarkably swell.
Cool. Me?
What are you doing? This ain't the first day in kindergarten. Don't be shy.
She's so pretty.
Oh, you think she's cute, then go show her your Chicano magnetism.
I can't. I'm a cholo. And look at her. She's so perfect. I can't find her in the yearbook. It's not Gloria or Iris. Maybe it's the girl with her eyes closed. I hate it when you take a picture and your eyes come out like this. Or maybe when your face comes out like this. It's not her either. I've been in school for 3 years and I can't believe I've never seen her. She's a real beautiful nerd girl. And I'm a cholo. Cholo for life. My goddess, I can't take them off.
I'm sorry, I'm late, Miss Ponce. I have a really good lie. I mean, a really good reason. My brother ate a whole box of crayons and I had to take him to the emergency room. Okay, I'm sorry. I promise it won't happen again. I'll make sure the little brat doesn't need any more crayons.
¿Qué pasó? What's wrong with you?
Nothing.
How come you're dressed like that?
I want to be a nerd too.
Get out of here.
Serious, I got an amphorm just like you.
Oh, I will hit you, man.
You know that nerd girl from yesterday? Well, I like her a lot.
You can't like her. I like her.
Man. Oh, no, Miss Ponce, we're not fighting. I'm just checking his head for piojos, lice. You know, they run in his family.
Yeah, on my dad's side. You can't like her. I like her.
Yeah, Ceci.
When did this happen?
You know, last night in bed. You know, I never really had a girlfriend.
What are you saying?
I'm saying I never really had a girlfriend. You know, I put on like I'm all suave y todo, but I'm not. And all the fights I got into, man, I lost them all.
What are you saying?
I'm saying I think I have a chance with this nerd girl. I thought maybe my aunts and her aunts could like kick it, you know?
Impossible. I got my eye on her.
What you got there, Holmes? I mean, what is it that you're pursuing so intently?
The yearbook. She's gotta be here.
Hey, your hairnet's cool. I've been a nerd for like 3 hours and I already miss being a cholo, but those days are gone.
I'm sorry I'm late, Miss Cardenas. My mocoso brother eats some criollos and I had to take his little nalgas down to the emergency.
I had to go with the dude for moral and spiritual support. Nah, we won't be late ever again because Freddy's brother ate the whole box. What was that, Miss Cardenas? That was Joaquin's excuse? Bro, you gotta stop stealing our excuses. That was our excuse. And what are you wearing?
That new guy? He was one delicious looking brownie on the menu.
Like the best dish on the menu.
Ajá, tamal.
Just like these bread fries.
¿Cómo?
You didn't see his cool walk? Someone like this.
That's cute, Susana, but he was much more impressive than French fries. I was born for him.
But you had your eyes on Dean.
I know I did, but I like this guy too.
You can't have a mom. Listen, you stick with Junior Einstein and let me and Susana fight over this dude.
Yeah, best chola wins.
Yeah, you're right. It's just, I'm like all caught up on this role that I invented for myself. Oh, sorry, Mrs. Cardenas. I had a wedgie. I had to stand up.
I knew this was gonna come back on you. Just when you're getting over vatos locos, here comes one that's worth keeping.
You know, he seems familiar, que no? Like we've seen him before.
I had that feeling también.
He reminds me of that nerd Martin, but nah, it can't be. Was that Miss Cardenas? Why am I standing up? Oh, you know, just straining the picture, you know, us Braves in our school pride.
Yeah. Check the yearbook. He's gotta be in there.
What's up, homeboy? You had a slumber party at Junior Einstein's?
There he is.
Hey.
Calmate. I've heard of this dude. Good things, también.
He ain't nowhere. And we were looking in the yearbook and we couldn't find you anywhere.
I'm there. Have you checked the science club? I was invisible to you two, just because I was different. Let me give you a hint.
Impressive calculator.
Be cool, girl. There's a time and place to play with my calculator.
Wait. You can be Martin, the Chicano nerd?
Former Chicano nerd. These homies fixed me up.
That's right. A little bit of bundle to his cuerpo and presto, you have one of these.
Transmissions, no?
Transformation, tonto. How many times do I gotta tell you?
Well, you're looking really good, Martin.
I saw him first.
Mentirosa, I did.
I gotta be direct with you, too. I'm looking for Ceci, the little red riding hood of mi corazón, and the nerd girl. She was with you yesterday.
She's real busy right now.
Real busy.
The dilemma, two types of love. But here's my one chance. I'm attracted to Ceci, but I'm also attracted to this other item también.
Hi, cutie. I ain't gonna snag no girl.
You look muy familiar.
No, I'm just your basic nerd.
No, there's something special. Cool calculator.
Oh, it's a Texas Instrument, model T136X.
I like your hair too. You haven't seen this child named Ceci. She called one of my homies a bad word in the second grade.
She made me cry when she called me en caca. Not me, no Ceci.
No, I haven't met her. But I hear she's real nice.
Well, I like her. And I like you también.
Man, I've been a cholo all my life. And he's getting all the girls after one date.
You do? You like me?
And I like your glasses.
You know how to flatter a girl. Hey, I saw that battle first, Ceci.
Ceci? I used to like you when I was a nerd. I thought about you all the time. I cried 96 lagrimas.
I feel the same way. Sometimes when I listen to the radio, I'll picture you in the songs. Molecules, fluctuating molecules, floating in the calculus of our feelings.
I love that oldie, but a goodie. We changed, Ceci. Look at me. Look at you. But meet me halfway.
Here? Right now? In front of these people?
Close your eyes. No peeking. Okay, open sus ojos. You've heard of Romeo and Juliet, but we're the real thing.
That's so romantic.
Go, tell me how you feel.
I don't dress like this.
Don't let your goddess keep you back.
Hey, Susana saw you, your name, and hers together. It said, Susana con Joaquin.
Hi, cutie pie. You looking muy fina.
Why are you dressed like that?
I can't explain, but I can explain how I feel.
Like a macho. You know, me and we saw your name at the mailbox. You spelled eternity wrong. You sure your feelings are true?
Yes, I'm for real. R-E-E-L.
It's close enough.
What about us? Me and Freddy, we never get anybody.
Hey, Freddy. You know, I used to have a big crush on your older brother.
He's in the Marines, Kendall.
He's in the Marines, but he's a barber now. You know, when I go to the Marines, I'm gonna drive a tank.
Qué ambición.
This is sorry. I feel bad. I never get anybody. I never get to write my name Tito with Araceli or Tito with Maria. I didn't even get to say the line chorizo con huevos. Everyone's got somebody except me. My mom has my dad, and my dad has his beer and TV. My sister has somebody, and you guys got something sweet happening. Even my dog Humo has a girl dog, a little poodle from down the block. Espérate, wait a minute. I see someone right there. Espérate, ¿tienes novio?
Molecules, fluctuating molecules, floating in the calculus of our feelings.
Tanto tiempo disfrutamos este amor, nuestras almas se acercaron, tanto así que yo guardo tu sabor, como tú llevas también sabor a mí. Si negaras mi presencia en tu vivir, bastaría con abrazarte y conversar. Tanta vida yo te di, que por fuerzas tienes ya sabor a mí. No pretendo ser tu dueña, no soy nadie, yo no tengo vanidad. En mi